Hi friends, I welcome you for this session 10 of series of lectures on module 3 of the course Engineering Physics with course code 18PHY12/22. In the previous 9 lectures, we discussed about the various topics of module 3, starting from Maxwell's equations up to the optical fibers. Today, myself, Dr. Mahesh Lohit K.S., Associate Professor and Head, Department of Physics, ATME College of Engineering, Mysuru, here to discuss the numerical problems, that is the solving of some numerical problems of this particular module 3. So, today in this session we shall solve numerical problems on the divergence of a vector field. We shall also solve numerical problems on the curl of a vector field. So, before we start solving the numerical problems on divergence of a vector function and curl of a vector function, let us recall the formulae and equations related to divergence and curl of vector functions, and also recall the interpretation of the values and functions that are obtained by calculating the divergence and curl of a vector function. Let us consider a vector function representing a field, a vector field, let it be A, and is given by Ax into I cap plus Ay into j cap plus Az into k cap. This is the vector function. The divergence of this vector function is given by del dot A. Here del is the vector differential operator. When it operates on A with that as a dot product, we get this, that is dou Ax by dou x plus dou Ay by dou y plus dou Az by dou z. This right hand side is a scalar quantity. Therefore, it can take three types of values. It can take a positive value, it can take a negative value, it can also take a zero value. So, let us have the interpretation for the same. If the divergence of a vector field is positive at a given point or in a region, then that region is the source of the flux of the vector field. Okay. And also, there is another interpretation wherein, if we consider a region, there are flux lines that are entering this region and there are flux lines that are moving out of the region, that are emerging out from the region or emanating from the region. Then if the divergence is positive, number of flux lines that are emanating is more when compared to the number of flux lines that are entering. Similarly, if the divergence of a vector field is negative, then this point or region in the vector field behaves like a sink of the flux of the electric field, flux of the vector field. And there is another interpretation here. If we consider a region, then in case of this negative divergence, the number of flux lines that are entering this region will be more when compared to the number of flux lines that are leaving. And the third type is zero divergence. Here, the vectors in the vector field are of equal magnitude and they are parallel. There is no divergence here. And there is another interpretation wherein, if you consider a region of space then the number of flux lines that are entering is equal to the number of flux lines that are leaving this particular region. So, this is the interpretation that we can have as far as this divergence is considered. The next operation is the curl of a vector function A and is given by del or nabla cross A. Here nabla or del is the vector differential operator, and the vector function A or vector field A is represented by the vector function A is equal to Ax into I cap plus Ay into J cap plus Az into K cap. So, this is curl of A, that is nabla cross A. It is expressed in the form of a determinant as shown here. It is I cap, J cap, K cap, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, Ax, Ay and Az. The cross product, the result of a cross product is a vector function denoted by S here. Again, it's a vector and it represents a vector function. And this vector function at a given point or in a region can take a positive value, a negative value, or a zero value. If the curl of a vector function is positive, then the swirling or curling of the vector field is anti-clockwise. Anti-clockwise. So, anti-clockwise swirling or curling is always represented by a positive value. And if it is a negative value, it's a clockwise curl. And if the value of the curl is zero, then there is no swirling and the vector field is said to be irrotational. Irrotational. So, positive curl for anti-clockwise swirling, negative curl for clockwise swirling, zero curl, there is no swirling and it is said to be irrotational, the vector field is said to be irrotational. Similarly, if the divergence is zero, then the vector field is said to be solenoidal, solenoidal. Okay, there is no divergence. So, the field lines may exist in close paths, right? So, it is solenoidal. So, these are the basics, and we studied different formulae, that is one corresponding to divergence and the other corresponding to the curl of a vector function. This is the first problem. Given a vector function A is equal to 3x square ax cap plus half y square z ay cap plus 3xy az cap. Ax cap, ay cap and az cap are the unit vectors. And ax is a function of x, ay is a function of y and z, az is a function of x and y. So, we have to calculate the divergence. We know that the divergence of a vector function is given by this formula, this equation. So, here 3x square is ax, half y square z is ay and this 3xy is az. So, if we substitute for this, we get this equation. Then we need to differentiate. This is a partial differentiation. This is differentiation along x axis, y axis and z axis. So, if we differentiate 3x square with respect to x, we get 6x, and this differential is half into 2y into z. Since this is a partial differentiation, the differentiation with respect to that particular variable can be taken. The other variables are considered to be constants. For example, here z is a constant and we need to differentiate this with respect to y, only we need to differentiate y square. So, differential of y square is 2y, half into 2y is y, and we get yz. And this differential is 0 because there is no z term here, both xy and 3 are the constants. So, therefore, the divergence of this vector field A is represented by a function 6x plus yz. Now, this is a vector again a function, this is a scalar function. Sometimes you may be asked to calculate the divergence of a vector field at a given point, say 1 comma 1 comma 1, then we need to substitute the values for x, y and z here, 6 into 1 plus 1 into 1. So, it becomes 7, it is a scalar value, it is a positive value. Therefore, this point that we have considered behaves like a source of the flux. This is the type 2 problem. Prove that this vector function is solenoidal. So, vector function is said to be solenoidal if the divergence is 0. So, if the divergence of a vector field, that is del dot A, is equal to 0, then such a vector function is called solenoidal. What is the meaning of that? Here, since the divergence is 0, there is neither source nor sink. So, the whatever the, if you consider, even if you consider region, the total number of flux lines entering is equal to total number of flux lines leaving, or all the flux lines, you know, at all points the mega vector field, the vectors in the vector field have the same magnitude and direction. Or it may also represent the curling of the field. The curling of the field means the flux lines, they exist in closed paths. Hence, this sort, this type of vector field is said to be solenoidal. It is curling. There is no divergence here. It exists in closed paths. So, let us solve this. So, the condition is if the vector field is said to be solenoidal, then the divergence of the vector function is 0. So, let us consider the divergence. Divergence is given by this equation. We know the values of x, y and z, ax, ay and az. This is ax, this is ay and this is az. They are the functions of x, y and z. Then substitute here for ax, ay and az. So, if you substitute, we get dou by dou x of 3 y power 4 z square. Similarly, here ay and a z. So, if you differentiate the first term with respect to x, since there is no x term, this differential is 0. In the second term, there is no y term, therefore, this differential is 0. In the third term, since it is a partial differentiation, there is no z term and this is 0. Therefore, the divergence of this vector function is 0. So, again I repeat, if the divergence is 0, the interpretation is the flux of the field, they are curling, or the flux lines they are parallel, and the field has equal magnitude, it maintains the same value and direction at all points. This is the second type of problem. So, hence A is solenoidal. This is another type of problem with respect to the divergence. Determine C, the value of C such that the vector A is solenoidal. Vector function, it is a vector function. You can see this Ax, Ay and Az are the functions of x, y and z, which are the spatial coordinates. So, this A has spatial variation. The vector A is represented by, that is this vector function A is represented by this equation, and it is solenoidal. It means the divergence of A has to be 0. We shall calculate the divergence and we shall equate the same to 0 to calculate this value of C. So, the condition is for the divergence, for the vector field to be solenoidal, the divergence has to be 0 here. So, this is the equation for divergence. So, dou A x by dou x plus dou A y by dou y plus dou A z by dou z, that is equal to 0. And we know the values of A x, A y and A z. So, these are the values x plus A y, y plus B z, x plus C z. Let us do the substitution. Let us substitute for A x, it is x plus A y. Here dou of y plus b z by dou y, the second term, third term is this x plus c z by dou z, dou of x plus c z by dou z. Here in this term there is no x, therefore, the differential is 0 and differential of x with respect to x is 1. Even here there is no y term in the second part. So, differential of y with respect to y, that is partial differential of y with respect to y is 1. And here if you take the partial differential, this term is x and there is no z term here, it is 0, but differential of c z with respect to z, that is partial differential, is c. So, we get 1 plus 1 plus c is equal to 0 and hence c is equal to minus 2. So, remember in all cases we consider the partial differentiation. So, it is the variation of the vector function along the three dimensions, and therefore, we consider partial differentiation. Now, the fourth problem is we have a vector function A given by this equation under square root x square plus y square a x cap plus under square root x square plus z square into a y cap. This a x cap and a y cap, they are outside the square root. We have to find the divergence of A at a given point. Now, we know that the divergence is given by this formula. So, we need to substitute. This is a x and this is a y. But a z is equal to 0. We can write this as plus 0 into a z cap. So, now this term is 0 and let us differentiate, substitute and differentiate, it is the partial differentiation. The differential of under square root x square plus y square with respect to x, that is partial differentiation, is 1 over 2 root x. See, we know that differential of root x d by dx of root x is 1 over 2 root x. So, therefore, the differential of this has to be 1 over 2 root x square plus y square. Then even we need to differentiate this x square plus y square. Y, you know, is a constant when we are differentiating only with respect to x, it is the partial differentiation. So, differential of x is 2 x into 2 x. These 2 and 2, they get cancelled. So, therefore, we get x by under square root x square plus y square. In the second term, there is no y term. So, both x square and z square, they do not contain a y term associated with them. So, if we differentiate, this becomes 0. So, this is already 0. So, therefore, the divergence of this vector field A is given by x by under square root x square plus y square. Now, it has been asked to calculate the divergence at a point 1 comma 2 comma 3. So, we can make the substitution for x and y. If we substitute for x, x is 1. Y is 2, therefore, we get 1 by under square root 1 plus 4. So, this is the value. So, if we calculate, it is 1 by root 5, it is 0.4472. So, that point is a source of flux of the field. So, in this chapter, as per the syllabus, we need to discuss only simple problems. Therefore, I have taken two problems as assignment for you. You can solve this these problems later, but I will give you hints to solve this. Here, we have a vector function that represents electric flux density D. It is 9 x cube a x cap plus 5 y square a y cap plus 2 z square a z cap coulomb meter square. The problem states, if the divergence of D represents the charge density rho v, find rho v at the point 1, 5, 9. So, there is a region of space, there are charges distributed, therefore, there is flux. Okay. Flux, let us say, and this flux density in this region is represented by this vector function. And as per the Maxwell's equation, we know that the divergence of D is rho v. This is the first Maxwell's equation, first Maxwell's equation. So, if we calculate the divergence of this vector function, we get the charge density. And this charge density is obtained as a function of spatial coordinates, then we substitute the values, we get the charge density value at that point. So, if you do that, for example, if you calculate the divergence and if you substitute 159 for x, y and z, you should get this value. The next problem is also of similar type. The vector function for electric flux density is given. So, this is the vector function here, right. So, you have to calculate the total charge within a volume of 10 power minus 14 centimeter cube or meter cube, sorry, this within a volume of 10 power minus 4 meter cube, say. So, how to calculate this? To calculate this, first we shall make use of this Maxwell's first equation, that is divergence of D is equal to rho v. You can calculate rho v, and again I am going to write the same region of space. There are charges that are distributed and there is electric flux density, say like this. Here I consider a small volume, and this volume is dv and the charge enclosed by this volume is dq. Then the density at a point inside this volume is volume considered is so small that the density throughout remains constant. Therefore, rho v is nothing but dq by dv. So, this implies rho v dv is equal to dq, which is nothing but the charge, the total charge enclosed by this particular small surface. So, that is what is asked here. Determine the total charge within a volume 10 power minus 14 meter minus 3 at a point 1 comma minus 2 comma 3. So, calculate this, you should get the density as 24 coulomb meter minus 3 and the charge is 24 into 10 power minus 14 coulomb, the charge enclosed by this small volume of dimension 10 power minus 14 meter cube is dq, which is nothing but 24 into 10 power minus 14 coulomb. So, these are the two assignment problems which you can solve on your own. The second part of the discussion is on curl of a vector function. The first problem is, find the curl of a vector function A given by x y into I cap, y z into j cap plus z x into k cap. So, the curl is given by this determinant. Here this is the determinant and we need to make the substitution for a x, a y and a z. These are the functions of the spatial coordinates. A x is x y, a y is y z, a z is z x. So, if we make the substitution, we get this determinant. Now we need to expand this. To expand this, first write equal to, first write this I cap, leave this row and leave this column. Now the product of these two means this operator dou by dou y operates on zx. So dou by dou y of zx, okay, then minus this product means dou by dou z operates on yz, dou by dou z operates on yz. So bracket here, this is the first term. Similarly, for the second term, this j cap has to be taken, leave this row and leave this column, this operates on this term and this operates on this term. So likewise, if you calculate, you will get this equation. And if you observe this equation here, there is no z term here, there is no y term here, therefore this takes a value 0. And this is a differential with respect to z, partial differential with respect to z, therefore you get y. So 0 minus y is minus y into I cap. Here this term is z because it is a differential of zx with respect to x, and this term, it has no z term, this is 0. So minus is there, minus z into j cap. Then the third part here, there is no x term here, this takes a value 0. Then dou xy with respect to y, that is dou xy by dou y. This is a differential of y. So therefore, this x is a constant. So this becomes y, sorry, x. And there is a negative sign here. So if we simplify this, 0 minus y is minus y, and z, this is 0, z minus is here, there is a minus here, minus z here and minus x. So therefore, minus of y I cap plus z j cap plus z k cap, this is k cap, is the curl of this vector function A. Again, it is a vector function. It is a function of y, Ax is a function of, this part is a function of xyz, this part is a function of xyz, this part is a function of xyz. The third, the second problem is, if vector A is represented by this equation or this function, then we have to find curl of A at this point. So curl of A is represented by this determinant, and here we have, this is Ax, this term is Ay with a negative sign, and this term is Az. If we make the substitution, so we have xz cube here minus 2x square yz and 2yz. If we make the substitution, if we expand this determinant, we need to expand this determinant. If we expand, we get the first term as Ax cap here, this operates on this, it is here, and this term operates on this, it is here. Similarly, we get the other two terms, and the differential of this is z, the differential of this is minus 2x square y, differential of this is 0 because there is no x term, differential of this is 2xz square, and differential of this is minus 4xyz, and the differential of this is 0. So therefore, this is 2z plus 2x square y, because when we differentiate this, this z differential with respect to z is minus 2x square y, minus into minus is plus. So we get this, the second part and the third part. If we simplify, we get this equation. Okay. So here you should remember, if we substitute the value 1 comma minus 1 and 1, we get this value. Having solved a few problems on divergence of a vector function, now let us solve a few problems on curl of a vector function. Here we have a vector function A represented by this function xy into I cap plus yz into j cap plus zx into k cap. So, we need to find the curl of this vector function. The curl of a vector function is represented by this determinant I cap, j cap, k cap, dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z. These are the partial derivatives, and ax, ay, az are the functions of x, y and z are spatial coordinates. So, here ax is xy, ay is yz and az is zx. So, substituting the same in the determinant, we get this determinant. We need to expand this. To expand this, so first consider I cap. So, leave this row and leave this column. So, I cap into this product minus this product. So, we can write this as I cap into dou by dou y operating on zx, dou by dou z operating on yz. So, here we have. So, dou by dou y operating on zx minus dou by dou z operating on yz. The second term is, we choose j cap here, then we leave this row and this column, then this operates on this minus this operates on this. So, dou z x by dou x minus dou x y by dou z into j cap. And similarly, the third term. So, when we consider the third term, we leave this row and this column. So, k cap into this operate, this operates on this term first, dou by dou x of y z and second dou by dou y of x y. So, this one. Now, the differential of this is 0. The differential of this is y. This is a partial differentiation. So, there is no y term here, both z and x are constants. When we take the partial differentiation of this function, since it has no y term and since z and x are constants here, considered to be constants here. So, this is 0 and this is y. This differential with respect to x is z, this differential is again 0. This differential with respect to x is 0 and this differential with respect to y is x. So, if you substitute, we get this minus y here, this differential is 0, this is minus y and here we get a z and there is a minus sign here, therefore, we get minus z and this differential is 0, but here we get a x and there is a minus x into k cap. So, finally, the curl of this vector function A is another vector function which is given by minus of y I cap plus z j cap plus x k cap. So, this is k cap, thus the solution. So, the next problem states, if vector function A is represented by this equation, then we need to find the curl of A at this point. So to find the curl of A, we have this determinant. So the Ax term is x is z cube, Ay term is minus 2x square yz, and Az term is 2yz. So we have the same here. Let us substitute this in the determinant. So this is the determinant. Now you know how to expand this. So this becomes first Ax cap into dou by dou y of 2yz, then dou by dou z of minus 2x square yz. So this is the first part, and similarly we can even calculate or write down the other terms. Second one, Ay cap into this operating on this term and this operating on this term, you will get the second term, and similarly you get the third term. So leaving this column and this row, Az cap into this term operating on this, this operating on this. Now after carrying out the partial differentiation, so this is a differential with respect to y, we get 2z. This is a differential with respect to z, we get minus 2x square y, and there is a minus sign, it becomes plus 2y plus 2x square y. So we have 2z minus plus 2x square y, because this is the differential of 2yz with respect to y, so we get z here. Similarly, the differential of this term is 0 because there is no x term. The differential of this term is differential, it is a partial differential. Differential of z cube is 3z square, so 3xz square with a minus negative sign here. So this is minus 3xz square into Ay cap. Then the last term, in the last term we have to differentiate this with respect to x, that is partial differentiation. X square, differential is 2x, this is minus 4xyz, so minus 4xyz, and this differential is 0 because there is no y term. So if we simplify this and simplify and we substitute the values 1, minus 1 and 1, if we substitute 1 for z and 1 for x and minus 1 for y, this becomes 2 minus 2, it is 0, so therefore there is no Ax cap term here. Then for the second term, this is 1 and this is also 1, it is minus 3, and multiplication with minus 1 becomes plus 3, plus 3 Ay cap. And the third term, so y has a negative value, that is minus 1, other two are 1, so therefore it is minus 4 into minus 1 is plus 4 into Az cap. So this is the value of the vector function at that particular point, 1 comma minus 1 comma 1. The third type of problem is, there is a vector function A and it is given by this particular function 3x square minus y plus az into ax cap plus bx minus 5y square minus 2z into ay cap plus 2x plus cy plus 3z square into az cap. So we have to calculate the values of A, B and C. We have A here, we have B here and we have C here. Given A is irrotational. If a vector function or vector field is irrotational, then the curl of that vector function is a 0 vector, just it is not just 0, it is a 0 vector, remember. So the curl of a vector function is a 0 vector. So here we have a 0 vector. We shall make the substitution for Ax, Ay and Az. This is Ax, this is Ay, and this is Az. So let us substitute, we have this. So the simplification, as usual, you have to expand this determinant. So it is Ax cap into this product minus this, okay, that is the first one. The second one is Ay cap into this product and this product. In the reverse order, say, that is dou by dou x on operating on this, dou by dou z operating on this. Then the third one, Az cap, is this operating on this, this term operating on this. So for Ax cap, so the terms are these two, this dou by dou y operating on this term, then dou by dou z operating on this term. Second one, I take another color so that it is clearly visible. So it is a y cap, then dou by dou x operating on this term, and dou by dou z operating on this term. And the last product, we have this a z cap, dou by dou x operating on this minus dou by dou y operating on this. So we have the equation here. So if we differentiate this, this is the differential with respect to y. So these two are constants, therefore they become 0, and this term is 1. Okay. So this term is c, not 1, this term is c, because it is cy, this is 0, this is 0, differential of cy with respect to y is c. Here there is no z term here, there is no z term here, there is a z term here. So differential of this is minus 2, minus of minus 2 is plus 2, so it is c plus 2. Similarly here, there is no z x term here, 0, 0 differential. So differential of this is 2 minus, there is no z term, differential is 0, there is no z term, differential is 0, this is a. So here we have 2 plus a is, you know, 2 plus a into a, 2 minus a, not plus a, because there is a minus sign here, 2 minus a into a y cap. Then similarly here the third term, dou by dou x of bx minus 5y square minus 2z, there is no x term here, there is no x term here, so this is b, and here there is no y term, there is no y term, there is a y term here, minus 1, minus of minus will become plus 1, so b plus 1. So finally we get this c plus 2 into ax cap minus 2 minus a into ay cap plus of b plus 1 into a z cap is equal to 0 vector. 0 vector could be written as 0 into a x cap minus 0 into a y cap plus 0 into a z cap, equating the respective terms and equating it to 0. So we get the values of x, y, a, b and c. So c plus 2 is 0. Minus of 2 minus a is 0, b plus 1 is 0, therefore a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 1, and c is equal to minus 2. These are the answers. With this, we have come to the end of today's session. Before closing the session, I would like to remind you about the two points that are discussed and which are very important. If the divergence of a vector field is 0 at a point, then it is said to be solenoidal, that is, vector field is said to be solenoidal. If the curl of a vector field is 0 at a given point, then the vector field is said to be irrotational. And also by calculating the divergence, we can calculate the charge density at a given point in a vector field of flux density, and we can also calculate the charge enclosed by a given volume. So with this, we shall close this session. Wish you all the best. Have a great day. See you.